Hello students, welcome to the third session of your first year biology chapter 1, that is living world. So far in first session and second session we had discussed about particular things like living criteria or how we can call the organism a living thing or living organism. We have studied about 5 different criteria over there and which or based on which we can consider whether the organism is living or not. Apart from this one, we also have studied regarding nomenclature, its rules and how to write a scientific name. So apart from that, we have started regarding diversity in living world or in living organisms. Last class we did stopped till rules of nomenclature. Now next is we have to learn some terms, that is first term is classification. So what is the necessity of classification is because we have to categorize or group the organisms into different categories. Now for example, plants, animals, in case of animals, if you see a dog, a cat, whenever I say a dog or a cat, you can imagine what are the characters of this dog or cat. If I particularly say a pug, maybe Alsatian, you can imagine certain forms or certain types of characters which is restricted to only Alsatian or only pug. Even in case of cats also or in case of mammals. Now for example, mammals, if I say, you can generally imagine that they have external ears, bodies filled with hair, they have mammary glands, all these are the characters that comes into your mind. Similarly in case of plants, if I say wheat or coconut plant, you can imagine what are the characters, whether they have soft stem or woody stem, herbaceous stem. These are the characters what you can imagine whenever a plant or an animal is told. Based on these observable external characters, we normally classify the organism into different categories. That is what is classification. So classification means it is grouping of organisms into different categories. So the scientific term used to represent category, that is called a taxa. So taxa means it is the scientific term used to represent category. Now I told that classification means classifying the organism into different categories. Those categories can be scientifically called taxa. So that is how you represent the category scientifically, that is taxa. Next is taxonomy. So taxonomy means it is the process by which you can classify the organisms into different taxa. The process by which you can systematically classify the organism into different taxa is termed taxonomy. Now how will you categorize the organism? Taxonomy uses certain basic rules. Now what are those basic rules is morphological character, anatomical character, cell, their development, their multiplication, their structure, all these will be considered while you represent an organism under different taxa. So here in together, if you see, while you classify the organism, you will be studying or identifying, understanding the organism properly before you place it in a particular taxa. So that is how you identify and represent, and the process is termed taxonomy. Now there is one more term when you classify the organism, that is called systematics. Systematics, the term systematics was taken from Latin. The term Latin is, or the term which was chosen from Latin is systema. So here systema means, it is a Latin word, it is the meaning of the systema means arrangement of organisms. So to define systematics, it is systematic arrangement of organisms into different taxa. That is what is called systematics. Carolus Linnaeus, he did mention about this arrangement in his book. The name of that book was Systema Naturae. So Systema Naturae, it is the book written by Carolus Linnaeus, who in his book mentioned about the systematic arrangement of organisms into different taxa. Particularly to mention, in this Systema Naturae book, what is the difference between about taxonomy as well as Systema Naturae? I told you that when you represent taxonomy, you have to consider the cell structure, cell multiplication, external characters, internal characters, etc. But I did not mention about evolution. Systema Naturae book is very much different from the taxonomy what I have explained, because here in Systema Naturae, Carolus Linnaeus also did consider some of the evolutionary characters to represent the organisms and to get the connecting link between two different organisms. So that is how Systema Naturae or Carolus Linnaeus point of view was different from only taxonomy, because he also included some of the evolutionary characters when there was arrangement of or systematic arrangement of organisms into different taxa. That is about diversity in living world. Next we'll be studying about taxonomic categories. So I'll write the hierarchy. Now normally the categories are arranged according to hierarchy, where you can separate the individual organism from a group of them. So we'll be representing this hierarchy in ascending order. So it will be represented as species, genus, family, order, class, phylum or division, and finally kingdom. This is the representation of taxonomic hierarchy. Okay, so the arrangement will be species, genus, family, order, class, phylum or division, and finally the kingdom. So we'll learn about each of the category and what are included in each of the category. First one is species. So we'll start from the base or the single unit, that's its species. When it comes to species, here it includes individual organism. That means you can identify, or an individual organism gets its own identity. You can separate an individual organism from the group. So here if you compare different species together, you can find some of the similar anatomical as well as morphological characters. When it comes to species, for example, if you see Mangifera indica, Panthera leo, Panthera tigris, Solanum nigrum, Solanum tuberosum. These are all the some of the examples. Now if you see in the first example, indica, Mangifera indica, indica represents the specific epithet. We have studied this in last class. And in Panthera leo, leo, and Panthera tigris, tigris, Solanum nigrum, nigrum, and Solanum tuberosum, tuberosum. So the in first example indica, next is Leo and Tigris, Nigrum and tuberosum. All these represents the particular species, whereas Mangifera, Panthera, Solanum, these include the genus name. So this is what we had studied in a binomial nomenclature, where two scientific or two names are given, in which first name represents the genus and second name represents the specific epithet or species. So when it comes here, so Indica, Leo, Tigris, Nigrum, Tuberosum, this represent individual organism, where if you see genus here, genus may have more than one species, but species is always individual. So here species represent individual organism, and the two different species will be having similar characters. So that is about species. Next we'll go to next category, that is genus. So genus include different types of species. Here also the similarities will be very much more compared to just like species. So genus will be having more number of species. So for example, if you see here, Panthera, Leo, Panthera, Tigris. Leo and Tigris are two different organisms. Leo, lion, Tigris is tiger, but both belong to same genus. One more is there, Panthera pardus, that is leopard. So here Panthera pardus also belongs to the same genus, that is Panthera. Here also Solanum nigrum, Solanum tuberosum, both belong to genus Solanum, indicating that a genus may represent many species, two or more species, but the characters included under same genus will be having more similarities. That is representing the second category, genus. Next is family. So family, when it starts coming to the third category, that is family, here it is based on vegetative plus reproductive characters in case of plants. So family includes both the vegetative and reproductive characters in case of plants. Family includes most of the genus. So here species means individual organism, genus means group of species, family means it is group of genus. From family you can see the similarities getting reduced and differences between the organism starts to increase. Now if you see in case of family, here Panthera is a genus, Felis is also a genus. So Panthera represent big cats and Felis represent small cats. So both of this belong to a common family, that is Felidae. Felidae is the family to which Panthera and Felis belongs to. If you take plant example, Solanum, Datura, Petunia, all these belong to family Solanaceae. So here group of genus are representing a family, or family includes group of genus. Solanaceae is the family which is including Solanum, Datura and Petunia genus, whereas Felidae is the family which includes Panthera and Felis genus. So that is represented in a family. Next hierarchy or next category, that is order. So when it comes to order, it includes group of different families. Just as in families, how we could find that there are more differences between the organisms, I'm talking about the characteristic differences. Same in case of order also, you can find that there are much more differences between the organisms in case of order. So when it comes to order, Thank you. when it comes to example for order, Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae. These both are the families which belong to a common order, that is Polymoniales. So here in order, it always represent the aggregate characters. So two of the families which belong to a common order, that is for plant example. For animal example, if you see, Felidae and Canidae, these both are the families which belong to a common order, that is Carnivora. So that is about order, that is the fourth hierarchy or fourth category, that is order, which represents the aggregate characters and which includes group of family. Next category, that will be class. Class again have lesser similarities, more differences, which includes group of orders. So example, so when it comes to class, as I have told, it includes group of orders. For example, Primata and Carnivora. When it comes to Primata, it includes human beings, gibbons, gorillas, everything come under Primata. So Carnivora, we have already discussed about Felidae as well as Canidae. So both of these order belong to a class, that is Mammalia. So both of them represents the class Mammalia. So here, order, group of orders, it represents class. Above this hierarchy, next is phylum and division. So when it comes to phylum, phylum is used in representing only animals. Whereas division, it is used in representing plants. So for plants, the hierarchy or the category will be species, genus, family, order, class, division, and then kingdom. Whereas when it comes to animals, it will be species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, and then kingdom. So phylum is representation for animals, whereas division is representation for plants. Division includes all the different categories of classes, where phylum also does the same but for animals. Next one is the kingdom. So kingdom, initially we had only two kingdoms, then three, and now in together after R. H. Whittaker's discovery, there are five different kingdoms. Kingdom normally represent the group of organisms. Like animals all belong to one group called Animalia, and all plants belong to one group called Plantae. So here it represents group of organisms with much more differences and very less similarities. As you move from up to down, the differences starts to reduce and similarity starts to increases. As you move from down to up, the similar character starts to reduces and differences starts to increase. That is about the representation of taxonomic hierarchy and taxonomic categories. So it starts with individual organism, that is species. Group of species is termed genus. Group of genus, it is termed family. Group of family is order. Group of order is class. Group of class, if it is representing animal, it is called phylum. If it is representing plant, it is termed division. And group of phylum is a kingdom, as well as group of division is also a kingdom. So this is how you categorize the organism into different taxa. Now, in taxonomic categories, each of this one, so group of all these, it is termed taxa. Group of categories is taxa. Individual one, that is called taxon. So species is a taxon, genus is a taxon, so is family, order, class, phylum, division, and kingdom. Each step is termed taxon, and group of this, it is termed taxa. So that is about representation of taxonomic categories. In next class, we'll be learning about four different organisms, their complete classification that includes human being, housefly, wheat and mangifera, that is mango. So apart from this one, you will also be studying about taxonomical aids. So that's all for today's class. Thank you.